ഇപ്പോൾ രക്ഷാപ്രവർത്തനത്തെക്കുറിച്ച് വിശദീകരിക്കുകയാണ്. ടീം ലീഡർ റെസ്ക്യൂ ടീമിന്റെ ലീഡറാണ് പ്രതികരിക്കുന്നത്.
Okay. Hi, this Squadron Patro. We are basically on behalf of Air Force and the Southern Command and Air Force base at Sulur. We are undertaking the relief operations over here in this area. Today in the morning, we had gone to the Patnamthitta area, and since morning, we've picked up 17 survivors and dropped about 500 kgs of relief material, including food and water packets for the survivors whom we were not able to address and survive. Some people who are also don't want to come up, but they are hungry, and so they need that immediate support in terms of food and water so that they can sustain. We tried and addressed those issues also, and now we'll be again going and continuously following this non-stop till the time we achieve a decent objective. The rain has been a bit less since last night, so that is why the water level is slightly subsiding, which should be a relief and should help us in providing relief to all the people. Yeah, the low lying areas which are there in the area are covered with water. There are few houses which have been submerged in this low lying area, and the areas which are more affected are which are immediately next to the river, where the water is also flown and the current of the water also is damaging the houses which are there adjacent to it.
What is the calculation? How we can do the
there is no landing area which is just next to the houses, so that is why we have to winch them or pick them up one by one, which is taking good amount of time. Boats and if available and if can go through that, will be able to take most of them out. But it's more counting on because the number of the survivors that we have, it's hoping that the rain stops and the water level recedes, we'll be able to then achieve a good amount of this thing. Otherwise, non-stop operations from the Air Force are continuing.
How long it will take?
It depends on the water level. The count of the people which are there is close to thousands whom we need to whom we can see are stranded in water location, but not everyone wants to be rescued. Some are waiting for the water level to recede, so it depends on the water level how quickly they goes down. The faster would be the some of them, because they are hoping the water level has been going down since yesterday, so they are not in a very critical state where they don't want to leave the place and come outside immediately. There are a lot of helicopters from Air Force, Navy, and also the transport aircrafts which are pressed into service. We are operating ex Trivandrum and also ex the INS Garuda at Kochi. There are also naval helicopters which have been pressed into the service. The figures are quite a lot.
Is it sufficient?
Yeah, it's sufficient. Round the weather holds, and round the if we are able to get a good window of continuing with our operations, the number is adequate for. Yeah, it is very critical because you have to maintain at a single point and pick them up one by one. So it involves criticality. The margin of error becomes less.
How you prioritize
in the air?
The most of the from the aerial view you can pick the people who are standing on the terrace, but there are few houses, like not everyone will stand outside in the terrace. In the morning we picked up a lady which who was quite old, almost in 80s and 90s, so she was not, when we reached that area, she was not waiting outside on the terrace. She was inside, and the family personnel got her out when the rescue started. So the estimate, you will get a generic estimate, but it will not be very accurate. Yeah, close to 1,000. Yeah, we've been operating mainly ex-Pathanthitta. The other helicopters have been operating in their respective areas which have been detailed.
Myself, Sergeant Raya from Garhwa. Just now we have rescued 17 people from two different locations and dropped at the designated points. The flood is too high, that a lot of people are waiting for the rescue. So again we are going.